So we're at kind of our lunch dinner right now.
Yeah. It's a ramen noodle place, which is super cool, in Chinatown, which is fun.
Yeah.
Across from a theater showing Oppenheimer and Barbie. We're gonna do a little walking around today, check out some shops, and then we have our show tonight, our last show, Moulin Rouge.
Yeah, so the plan right now is to just do some shopping and then eventually head to Moulin Rouge.
Yep. Bye.
M&M store. When I tell you, it smells like M&M in here. Not surprised. It's crazy. This is the M&M menagerie. Any kind you could ever desire.
Whoa.
Ready?
Yeah. Go for it. They're making you work for those.
You know you're at the M&M store when there's a floor that has a freaking roller coaster on it. That's how you know you're in the M&M
store. Just got out of the M&M store, walking to our theater. Look what we found. Too. I am very, very excited. Crazy. Welcome to the nightclub Moulin Rouge. It's quite a vibe in here. It's crazy awesome. The detailing is immaculate. 'Intermission, and these people came out to suck the glitter off the stage and the confetti from how much stuff they've thrown around already, and this is intermission. It's the next day at breakfast, so we're gonna do our critique and review on Moulin Rouge. And let me start by saying it was amazing. It was such a spectacle. Like, it had like pyrotechnics, and like they shot confetti every other dance number. And like they had new medleys in there that like aren't in the original. If you haven't watched the original movie, go watch it right now so you can tell what I'm talking about. My favorite part was probably that there was like a Britney Spears Toxic remix or in the beginning of the second act. And then there was also this one song that went, the Green Fairy song that had like Chandelier in it, and then like it turned into Roxanne, which is a great song. But even the slow ballads were great. There was the acting and the everything was phenomenal. But it wasn't Phantom, in my opinion, so it doesn't get a 5 for me. It gets a 4.9.
All right, so Gwen gave it a 4.9, but I gave it a 5. I thought it was so good. Like she said, the spectacle was just over the top. The costumes, the ambiance, like the theater had all been decked out with sort of that cabaret red light vibe. It was so cool, very immersive. And the new numbers were really good. It is a different story than what you're used to, but I think it worked really well with like a stage show. So I would highly recommend it. I know it's touring in the Fond du Lac area in the fall. Like, go see it. It's really good. So I give it a 5.
Also, one thing that impressed us was how many sets they kept just pulling out of the woodworks. Like,
oh yeah.
They had this whole stage in the beginning, but then, like, they closed the curtains, and it was Satine, and then it was Christian on the streets, and then it was,
yeah.
Every set imaginable. They're, like, little apartment flat. It was crazy.
Yeah. Lots of diversity in the set. And the lighting. Everything was just so dramatic.
I know.
Which lends itself to the show, but the sets were huge and technical. The lighting was dramatic and constantly changing. The costumes, the choreo, like, the choreography was insane. I think that for to be in the show, you had to be a little bit more of a dancer than a singer because
right.
there was so much.
I believe that as well.
Yeah, great show.
Bye.